In this example, we are given that a neutron with some initial kinetic energy strikes a stationary helium atom. And we are required to find the minimum initial energy of the neutron for which inelastic collision may take place. We need to take here the mass of helium is equal to 4 times that of the neutron. Say if we consider this helium plus ion or a hydrogenic atom. And this is the neutron which is coming with some initial kinetic energy with a speed v at a strikes. We know that for maximum kinetic energy loss, perfectly inelastic collision mechanically should take place in which after collision the two particles, the helium and neutron will move together. Say these will move with a speed v1. We can simply write here initial momentum was mv and final momentum as mass of neutron as m and that of helium we can take as 4 times the m. So, it will be 5mv1. This will give us the final speed of combined system will be v by 5. Now, in this situation, we can find out the maximum kinetic energy loss. In this situation is delta k, which is k initial minus k final. Initial kinetic energy is half mv square minus final kinetic energy is half. Total mass of the system here is 5m. So, it can be written as 5m multiplied by it is v by 5 whole square. On simplifying, we'll get it this half mv square and the second term here it will become 1 by 10 mv square. And on further simplifying, we'll get it 4 by 10, this is 2 by 5 mv square. This is the maximum loss in kinetic energy, which can be absorbed by the helium plus ion to get excited. Now, in this situation, we are able to find the minimum initial energy so that inelastic collision may take place. So, here we can simply write minimum energy required to excite HE plus is, this can be simply written as excitation from n equals to 1 to n equals to 2, which will be 10.2 Z square. And here it will be 10.2 multiplied by 4 as for helium Z is equals to 2. So, this will be 40.8 electron volt. This is the energy in units of electron volt. So, in this situation for minimum energy here, this 2.5 mv square should be equals to 40.8 electron volt energy. So, in this situation we will get mv square is equals to 5 by 2 multiplied by 40.8. which is here 102 electron volt. And the minimum kinetic energy of neutron for which the phenomena can take place here is half mv square, which is 102 by 2. This will be 51 electron volt. That will be the answer to this problem.